I am Carrie, Bear Chief, and we are on the Blackfeet Reservation, and we are at the home of Lynda Beaudry.
Hi. Okay, this was like, I want to say maybe 5 or 6 years ago. Me and my family were out at St. Mary's Lake, and we were on the boat and had a nice picnic and everything, and it was really like getting dark when we started loading the boat and to come back to town. And we got to divide up on the divide there, and the moon was so beautiful. It was dark, or not really dark, but I mean it was, you know, getting dark. And I noticed the moon, how big and beautiful and silvery it was, and I started to try to take pictures of it. And I had this little digital camera, and I started taking pictures of the moon, and my son told me, wait till we go around that hairpin turn up on top of Divide as you come down. And he said, and that moon will be on your side and you can take pictures of it. And I said, oh yeah, okay. And so I waited, and we went around that hairpin turn, and as you're coming down from the divide off of that hairpin turn, I start taking pictures. Now I remember taking 3 pictures, and then all of a sudden I something caught my eye in that little field below there, and there was this great big tree, like a burnt out tree, and I want to say it was about 6 foot tree. It was burned. And anyway, we came down that road, and I seen this like a movement by that tree, and I said, what is that? And Tony, my son, stopped the car, and we had a big Yukon, and that was what was pulling the boat, and he stopped it, and he said, what is that? And I said, well, that's what I'm asking you. Do you see it? And they were all looking out, my grandkids and my son and my daughter-in-law. And we were all looking at this thing down by this tree, and it was moving. Well, I start taking pictures again. I took maybe a couple more pictures, and it was standing like with its hands up like this. It was just standing there looking. And it was like taller than that tree. I would say maybe 7 feet tall. You know, I'm not a judge of height, but I would say that. But it was just standing there looking at us. And then all of a sudden, I hollered out, you know, Emuita Beast, Bumuket, you know. And I was telling it to help us, and I was praying that, you know, that it would hear our prayers and whatnot. And it started like moving, and then we kind of got scared. I kind of got scared, and I said, go, go, like that, and my son started out. And nobody said anything for a long time. And then all of a sudden, the next day, people began to hear about this incident that happened, that we actually saw a Bigfoot, and took pictures of it. And my son was working for a cable company here at that time, and he had one of those big Mac computers, and he took the pictures and enhanced them, and there is something standing there, and it definitely it was human-like, very, very tall, way taller than that burned-out tree. And this man named Bruce got a hold of us, and he said that he sent for this guy named Tom Biscardi, who is searching for Bigfoot. He has that show, like a series, and it's called Searching for Bigfoot. And all of a sudden, he was at my son's door. Now, it's crazy because we're always calling my daughter-in-law Bigfoot because she has big feet. I'm sorry, Billy, but anyways, and this guy standing there, and he said, hi. He said, I'm Tom Biscardi, searching for Bigfoot. And she said, well, you found me. It was really funny. But anyways, they talked, and he wanted me to go out and show him the area where it was. He wanted to see the pictures, but that night I told my son, I don't want you to put those pictures up. I don't want them printed. I want you to take them off my camera. I want you to take them off of that computer, because this is a spirit. I think it's a spirit, and I don't want, you know, if it wanted to be known, it would have been known. We would have found bones. We would have found smaller, animal-like creatures, but we haven't found anything, and I really don't. I think it's a spirit, and it just should stay that way, and people should just respect that. But it was, I took the man out there and showed him where it was at, and I also took him up behind Crystal Creek Lodge. There's a fenced off area, and there's a big footprint in there, and it's people putting cigarettes there and offerings and whatnot, and I took him there too. But those are my stories of my Bigfoot experiences, and I would have had pictures for you ladies, but it's just something that I didn't want to do. I could have been famous.